Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we're gonna learn 50 words starting with C. We already saw starting with A, starting with B, now we are at C. Those words are gonna be verbs, adverb, adjective, noun, a bit of everything so you can learn differently. Few things that I want to address first is that you can get the PDF of this lesson at theperfectfrench.com. On Monday we saw how to conjugate irregular verbs ending in ER. Tomorrow we're gonna see 12 other ways to say yes. All the video I'm going to talk about today in this video, everything I refer to something or if after I think about something that could be interesting to add in this video, it's all going to be in the description box. For example, if you want to watch the 50 words starting with A or 35 words starting with B, well, they are all going to be in the description box. All the words today are followed by a sentence. If you want to try to use one of the words in a sentence, do it in the comment and I will make sure to correct you or just to let you know if you were perfectly right. The first word we're going to learn today is chasser. Chasser. Il chasse tous les week-ends. Il chasse tous les week-ends. Chasser is a verb ending in ER. It's one of the most regular type of verbs. The video is gonna be down below. Numéro 2. Un château. Un château. Il y a beaucoup de châteaux en Irlande. Il y a beaucoup de châteaux en Irlande. So château takes a X when it's plural. Numéro 3, un café. Un café. So in the sentence, je prendrai un café, s'il vous plaît. Je prendrai un café, s'il vous plaît. Prendrai is conjugated in future, a tense that we will see soon enough. And who say coffee? Say usually cream, la crème. La crème. Je ne prends pas de crème avec mon café. Je ne prends pas de crème avec mon café. So you can see that the negation here is divided in two. It's always divided in two in French. There's always a part before the verb and a part after the verb. Here it's ne and pas. Je ne prends pas. I don't take. Another verb. Commencer. Commencer. Je commence à apprendre le français. Je commence à apprendre le français. Next one, it's now an adjective. Chaleureux, chaleureuse. Because an adjective, when it ends in E-U-X, the feminine turns into E-U-S-E. It means warm, warmly. Cette pièce est chaleureuse. Cette pièce est chaleureuse. Next one is another verb, cacher. Cacher. To hide. Le chat se cache sous le lit. Le chat se cache sous le lit. Next one, un cactus. And this one is pronounced a bit differently because you're not supposed to say to pronounce the S at the end, but in this case we do. Un cactus. Un cactus. Elle préfère les cactus. Elle préfère les cactus. And if you're terrible at plants like me, well, you have cactus. Next one, le corps. Le corps. So we don't pronounce the P or the S. It's one of those ones as well, like cactus, with a different pronunciation because technically we should pronounce the P, but we don't. Le corps. Le corps. La biologiste étudie le corps humain. La biologiste étudie le corps humain. Next one, un citron. Un citron. A lemon. Peux-tu acheter des citrons? Peux-tu acheter des citrons? Another verb, conduire. Conduire, to drive. Il va apprendre à conduire avec moi. Il va apprendre à conduire avec moi. This one, everybody loves puppies. Un chiot. Un chiot. Nous adopterons un chiot bientôt. Nous adopterons, Link, un chiot bientôt. Everybody likes to receive a gift. Un cadeau. Cadeau. Il a déjà choisi son cadeau. Il a déjà choisi son cadeau. Un cahier. Cahier. So we don't pronounce the H. Cahier. Cahier. A notebook. Elle a beaucoup de cahiers. Elle a beaucoup de cahiers. This one is perfect for January. Un calendrier. Un calendrier. A calendar. J'ai besoin d'un nouveau calendrier. J'ai besoin d'un nouveau calendrier. Next one, un canapé. Un canapé. A couch. Le chien dort sur le canapé. Le chien dort sur le canapé. This one, une carotte. That was mine. Une carotte. So as you can see, we write it really differently than in English. For us, it's one R, deux T. One R, deux T. Un R, deux T. For you, it's the opposite. So remember that. Je vais faire un gâteau à la carotte. Je vais faire un gâteau à la carotte. Une ceinture. Une ceinture. Il a acheté une nouvelle ceinture. Il a acheté une nouvelle ceinture. Next one, le champagne. Champagne. Ils serviront du champagne. Ils serviront du champagne. So just for you to know, because a lot of people actually don't know that champagne is actually the same thing as cava or just more or less sparkling wine. It's called champagne because it's made in the area of France called Champagne. You buy the product from there. If it's not exactly made there, you are going to buy the exact same product, probably 3 times cheaper. But if you want to spend, you know, a lot of money on champagne, that's up to you. Another verb, charger. Charger. Elle charge son téléphone. Elle charge son téléphone. Châtain. 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 It's a kind of brown, right? Ses cheveux sont châtains. Ses cheveux sont châtains. This one has quite difficult pronunciation. Chatouiller. Chatouiller. To tickle. Chatouiller. So, touiller. Ouiller. Ouiller. So, we don't pronounce the L. Remember, the L is always, always like a long E. Here, it makes it a bit complicated because it's O-U-I-L-L. So, it's ouiller. Ouiller. Hope that makes sense. Elle n'aime pas qu'on la chatouille. Elle n'aime pas qu'on la chatouille. Une chemise. Une chemise. Il a taché sa chemise blanche. Il a taché sa chemise blanche. Les cheveux. Les cheveux. Elle se brosse les cheveux tous les matins. Tous les matins. Elle se brosse les cheveux tous les matins. So, les cheveux is always plural. Unless you're talking about exactly one of your hair. You can't even see it because it's so small. Exactly one of your hair. For example, oh, you have a hair on your shirt or something like that. You're specifically talking about one hair. Otherwise, it's always, always plural. Chez moi. Chez moi. And it means at my house, at my place. Veux-tu venir chez moi? Veux-tu venir chez moi? Another verb, choquer. Choqué. Je suis choqué par ses actions. Je suis choqué par ses actions. I am shocked. A number this time, 50. 50. 50. Mon père a 50 ans. Mon père a 50 ans. Another adjective, collant, collante. So, collant is a masculine. Collante, féminine. Mes mains sont collantes. Mes mains sont collantes. My hands are sticky. Combien? Combien? How much? Combien coûte ce pantalon? Combien coûte ce pantalon? Comment? Comment? Comment vas-tu? Comment vas-tu? How are you? Un concombre. Un concombre. J'ajoute du concombre à mon eau. J'ajoute du concombre à mon eau. Connaître. Connaître. That's one of the really irregular verbs. Connaître. To know. Je le connais bien. Je le connais bien. Costaud. It's an adjective and it's also a very, very casual way to talk. Costaud. It means strong. Costaud. Mon voisin est costaud. Costaud. Very strong. Une couleur. Une couleur. Cette couleur est très vive. Cette couleur est très vive. This color is very bright. Un cours. Un cours. It's a course. Il commence un cours de français lundi. Il commence un cours de français lundi. And then we have the exact same word, cours, but it is now an adjective, so it's not right in the same way. This one ends with a T when a course ends with a S. So this one, court, or courte. So court, courte just means short, the adjective short, not the actual short. So in a sentence, ce short, because we also say a short for a short, is, what I'm saying in English, ce short est très court. Un couteau. Couteau. A knife. Les couteaux sont dans la cuisine. Une cravate. Une cravate. A tie. La cravate est bleue. La cravate est bleue. As you can see, that bleu has a E at the end because cravate is a feminine word, so bleu becomes a feminine adjective. Make sense? This one is another very casual way to talk. Crevé. Crevé. Crevé with only E in case of a masculine. Crevé et E in case of a feminine. It means exhausted. It's just, but it's more the way, it's very casual. So don't talk like that with your boss or anybody too important. So you can say, tu as l'air crevé. Tu as l'air, avoir l'air, to seem. Tu as l'air crevé. Another adjective, calme. Calme. The same as you. Le bébé est très calme la nuit. Le bébé est très calme la nuit. Another verb, casser. Casser, to break. Le chat a cassé le vase. Le chat a cassé le vase. An adverb now, certainement. Certainement. Certainly. C'est certainement une bonne idée. C'est certainement une bonne idée. Célèbre. Célèbre. Cette personne est célèbre. Cette personne est célèbre. Another verb, chanter. Chanter, to sing. Chanter est sa passion. Chanter est sa passion. Another adjective, show, showed. Show if it's masculine, showed if it's feminine, it means hot. Est-ce que l'eau est chaude? Est-ce que l'eau est chaude? Now the surgery. La chirurgie. La chirurgie. La chirurgie est planifiée pour demain. La chirurgie est planifiée pour demain. Another verb. Composer. Composer. Il compose une nouvelle musique. Il compose une nouvelle musique. This one is interesting. We use it a lot. Contre. Contre. Against. La table est contre le mur. La table est contre le mur. Next one, we're almost done. Créer. Créer. This one is quite a particular one because we have the E and then the E and the E. Créer. To create. Elle crée un nouveau design. Elle crée un nouveau design. Then one of the irregular verbs. Croire. Croire. To believe. Je crois en toi. Je crois en toi. I hope you enjoy, I hope you learned something. Don't forget to leave me a comment if you have a question about French, about literally anything, if you want to use one of those words that we just saw in the sentence down in the comment section, please do. I will make sure to correct you or to let you know if you made a great job. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video, it really helps me. You can connect with me on my Instagram, my Facebook page, this YouTube channel, the comment section, of course. I try to answer every comment I get, and I will see you soon for another lesson.